Hey guys, and welcome back to Oxygen Not Included, Clay's Amazing Space Colony Adventure Extraordinaire. My name's Twitchi, and we are, of course, in Twitchi's Tremendous Trojans, my amazing space colony, as I've just previously discussed. We are currently going around and picking up all the eggshell, because it turns out we've got quite a lot of eggshell on the floor, but that to actual real matters. We've got a whole bunch of slime that we need to dig up, because we are running out of oxygen, and algae is by far one of the easiest ways to get oxygen. We could be doing all sorts of funny stuff by electrolyzing water, and you know, that is going to be the second thing that we actually get on with today. You can see that we've got a basic setup down to the bottom left, and the reason that we need to do this, if I'm ever actually going to show you, is because these exosuit ports here, they need oxygen. They need oxygen badly, and unfortunately, no matter how much we have the pipes leading directly here, we don't actually seem to be getting a whole great deal of oxygen here. There are problems that caused this, but I'm a bit of a dum-dum at the moment, and I'm not sure exactly why. One problem I have identified is the fact that every now and then the oxygen line actually stops pumping. You can see it's doing it right now, and I'd like to avert that particular situation from happening. I would like to get continuous oxygen flow going, and the way that I'm going to try and do that is by putting two electrolyzers down. We might even end up putting two pumps down underneath it. I think that will be a great thing. Another thing that we are trying to do here, desperately working at, is the temperature shift plates. We have got an AntiEntropy hydrogen using a temperature nullifying device to the top right. One day I will actually learn the proper name for it. I know it starts with AntiEntropy, but you know, we'll get over that. You guys all know what I mean. Anyway, we've got one of those devices up in the top right. We've been pumping hydrogen into it, and it's been getting everywhere nice and chill. But we want to get the temperature shift plates to move the temperature from the water up into that area so that we can nullify it, as you know, it says it should be able to do. To my absolute horror, upon looking inside the electrical interface, we find out that a lot of the wires have not actually been upgraded to conductive wires, and I'm like, oh no, we gotta try and fix this. And indeed, a fix I do, or at least I queue up the job. I tell them to make a whole load of actual gold rather than gold amalgam, and it should all work out well. I'm looking through people's jobs, as I do quite often nowadays, trying to think if there's ways that I could shuffle people around, but I think before we actually get on with that, we're going to have to spend a lot of time kind of doing up the decor of the base. There's a whole load of things that I've not neglected, but you know, neglected around the base. This includes things like the artworks and just making places feel nice. One of the other things I had forgotten to do was put our new toilet in a nice room to make it a latrine, so I went ahead and did that. Staring nice and hard at our oxygen production facility here, because I'm looking at that new pump and I'm like, no, that's not where it needs to go. We're going to put it up and above. So I'm kind of using an old design that's more of a hangover from before the time that we had any sort of like filtering equipment in the game, and it would do all sorts of self-filtering for you, which is an amazing thing if you're trying to cut down on the power usage in your base. But you know what? I've got three natural gas geysers that are going around constantly producing energy for me, so I'm kind of all right with that. We're getting very, very close to getting all the shift plates into position here. I'm actually really looking forward to it. I really want to spend some time watching the flow of the energy go up the shift plates. I think that would be a beautiful thing to watch, and an amazing thing to understand how it works. Also, expanding out a couple more of the pump rooms down below, and thinking that maybe actually we want to put the pump right above the oxidizer. The electrolyzers, and see what happens there. The reason that I keep impatiently coming back to the cold water tank and trying to pump up the priorities of all the job there is because that we are running out of room in the hot water tank. And as we know, all the water needs to go from like the dirty sources, like the toilets or the sinks and stuff like that, into the hot water tank to boil it up and get rid of all the germs. It then comes into the cold water tank to cool it back down and put it back into our actual water supply. We've got two problems at the moment. Our water supply is super low, and our hot water tanks are starting to fill up, so we really want to make that a thing, to the point where actually the hot water tank is starting to have to deal with the pressure of the gases in there, so that's not great. So to distract myself, I keep bringing myself back to the oxygen generation over here. I keep trying to find out some sort of way of getting these constantly flowing, but unfortunately there always seems to be a small stall in the process where it just kind of hits a point where it stops moving. I'm going to bump the priorities up of all the slime digs, because as you can see, well, as you could have seen on the right there, our organic, we are completely out of algae. Not the best thing I've ever seen in the world. And there we go. The whole of the temperature shift plates are kind of like moving a little bit further into the colder area. and that's actually having an effect. The time that I saw it, we could see the blue encroaching a little bit more into the cold tank. Another thing that's actually happened is the hot water tank, the top hot water tank has emptied itself of all liquid. This was a problem that we had where we couldn't actually empty enough into the cold water tank. This is also why we're trying to expand it off to the right, but that's a different thing. But now that the top one is open, it's time to perform a few upgrades, get it cleaned out, and do some wonders there. The main thing is trying to get it cleaned out, because, like, don't you want a clean water tank? That would be amazing. We seem to have a little bit of polluted water still flowing, but that's fine. I think we've actually managed to get completely on top of it now. The only polluted water that I see is on the right-hand side, and it seems to be all contained. There are patches above of polluted ice, but with all the new roofs we put onto the access panels, that should sort itself out and keep nice and clean. Down with the oxygen again, and I feel like not enough major destruction of the local ecosystems has gone underway, so we're just going to start ripping up all the balm lily and any rock that happens to be in my way. I also put down a couple of mesh tiles just underneath the electrolyzer, or rather just under the place where I'm going to put another electrolyzer, and start just laying the foundations for the expansion there. The empty hot water tank is now completely cleaned out and ready to have everything taken out of it, and I'm starting to think about how we can automate the process of the switching of the tanks. You can see that we have a little water sensor up the top there, and I want to replace this shutoff valve, a manual shutoff valve, with an automated shutoff valve, so that should be nice and easy. A little disappointing to see that when I went and had a look at the temperature overlay, it seems like the cold is encroaching rather than the heat is dissipating, which, I suppose, like, from a macroscopic point of view, that is how things work. It just goes in either direction, but I would have liked to have seen some flow going that way, but you know, that's cool. There is ices dropped left on the floor. This kind of worries me. I'm not sure how this has actually happened. I presume someone was taking some ice from the cold biome to the store that we have above our water there, and nighttime must have happened or something like that. But anyway, here is actual downtime, and I don't know whether anybody dropped anything, but there does seem to be an Atmo suit just kind of strewn on the right hand side airlock there. I'm not sure why that is happening, but with all those temperature shift plates in place, we don't really need to worry about that cold water tank anymore. In fact, when I go back and have a look at it in a little while, it's kind of overperforming. Okay, so the pressure threshold is definitely something we want to try and figure out there. I want it to be that the moment we end up with some water above the vent, it stops pumping out from the water sieve, and therefore we still should have a little bit of time to get the dirty water out of the pipes and into the tank so that we can clean it, and then we've got nothing hanging around in the pipes, which has been a problem in the past, and I'm hoping that this will work out pretty well. But until we actually get everything built, we're just kind of holding everything up here. Obviously, with the hot water tank up top empty and this bottom one now over full, and in fact I put an air vent there in some sort of way of trying to relieve some pressure to continue the flow at some point, we are actually completely stalled on the water. So that's not the best. The other thing that's not the best is when I put the airflow tile in, it didn't actually flow quite in the manner that I expected it to, and this is because of stratification of the gases in there. There's some carbon dioxide underneath, and that's just kind of like holding the space where that water is. I was kind of hoping the water pressure would push the carbon dioxide up and then it would get shoved out the side. Turns out no, that's not what happened, but that's fine. Okay, so we've got people coming along and making some deliveries for this air pump, and I'm like, if I put this air pump above there, we're not going to be able to really be able to get to the other side and do any tweaks and stuff that we need. So let's expand the walkway here and figure out how we can make that work. Okay, the next thing I want to do is try and put a germ sensor in, but the problem is I'm trying to think about where the germ sensor goes around the pump. Obviously, if there are no germs in the water, we want to pump the water, but most of the germs are going to be dying from the bottom up, because that is where the heat is being applied, unless it's slime lung, and slime lung is a problem, but don't worry. So I feel like the fact that I've put the germ sensor at the bottom is a bad thing. Also, the fact that shutoff valve is not getting supplied with any power is an incredibly bad thing, and I don't want to go through a morning cycle without it being fixed. So we've got to get people to deliver the gold from all the way over the side there to the new conductive wire, and then they can hook up all the water and everyone will be happy. But for some reason, that didn't happen under conditions of red alert, and I'm not actually sure why. I can only assume it's some sort of restriction of materials. I can assume. I'm going to assume. It's all I can assume. But it's all there. This is what I'm trying to figure out right now. Why is it that we've got lots of gold strewn all over the floor over there, but it's not being put into the right place? My gut reaction is the fact that it's been allocated for other jobs. It could be, could not be. That's just what I feel. It would be nice to see if there was like some sort of overlay, some sort of like allocation overlay where you can click on an item and it shows you, much like the path of the duplicants, shows you the allocation line. That would be pretty good. Even if it was just like a straight line, I don't want to see a path or anything like that. I just want to see like, here is the thing you've clicked on, and there over there is the thing that it's going to, and here's the line connecting the two. That would be very nice. One problem that we have from the changeover of the hot water tanks is the fact that we've got people making a mess everywhere, and the base is full of people making messes. Thankfully, now that we've got the water valve in place and everything has been like fully automated, we should be able to keep on top of it. But we end up with things that need to be dealt with. In particular, the fact that Brum decided that like somebody's mess in the airlock was exactly where he wanted to fall asleep. Not ideal, Brum. Has to be said, not ideal. Another thing that I've done is to try and rip down that dividing wall in the middle there. I've upped the priority, so hopefully someone will get to it. And then we can have some room to put the second electrolyzer in. I fine-tuned the parameters of the germ detector there and send someone up to turn the switch on. So now it should fully be a self-automating, self-correcting process. It will only turn on when there are zero germs, as opposed to the tens of thousands of germs that are in there now. I turn up the temperature on the water pump a little bit just to get some more water moving into the actual tank, because you can see from our water tank that is on just on the very right-hand side of the screen there that we are getting quite low, less than two tiles worth in that wide open space there. Not ideal, if I'm to be honest with you. Not ideal. I was really hoping someone would have come along and fixed this by now. So I push up the priority just a little bit more, and with the advent of nighttime, I'm like, all right, it's over. I'm not going to be able to do this immediately. So I start thinking about where else I can fit an electrolyzer. Do I want to move one a little bit further over? No, I don't. But the fact that this is so full of food poisoning is actually a good thing. Slime lung is much more difficult to deal with in water than food poisoning is. With food poisoning, all you need to do is warm it up to 20 degrees. With slime lung, you've got to get it down to like under 10. If you've got one part of your tank underneath 10 degrees C, you're probably going to end up freezing parts of it, right? So, something that I want to point out here, with the ripping down of the dividing wall, we have set up a weird turbulent system in the gases up above. And you can see a lot of the oxygen has actually made its way over the crest of the door there and has dropped down to where the gas pressure sensor is, throwing off the entire system. Yay, we managed to break it in one fell swoop. Thankfully, we are working on a brand new system, so I'm not overly bothered about that. In fact, I'm even giving thought to completely cutting that side section off, so that'll be all right, right? And I'm going to use the same pressure sensor at the bottom to power both pumps, and I'm wondering whether that will work out well, because both pumps are trying to put into the same pipe, but we'll see how that does it. Looking around, I'm looking at the temperature of these shift plates now, and I'm noticing how things are getting down to like 16 degrees. It's sort of 20 degrees on the side where the pump is, and it's 16 degrees on the side where the pump is not. Now, that is problematic for reasons that I just explained about how we're going to, like, end up freezing one side of it as opposed to, like, pumping it out when it's chilled. With the orders given to put the pump down underneath the electrolyzers, we're very close to having the entire thing done, but, of course, we've still got to try and figure out how we're going to cap that pump at the top and put down its automation system and stuff like that. But that's all right. We need to wait for some of materials to appear. So we're going to follow these guys around while they do their thing up in the slime biome. And it turns out the majority of the guys who can go upwards aren't actually digging. They're just moving the slime that has been exposed, which I suppose is okay, because that means that we don't end up with too much slime on the floor. But I would also like to get a lot of the digging done, because there's also like things like algae up there and gold amalgam and things like that. Things that don't necessarily need processing but do need digging out of the wall. The pump has finally been put into place, and as much as I would like to say that's that system done, we've still got some wiring to get done around there. It's a little annoying. Another thing that's a little annoying is the fact that like these guys are partying so hard in front of the music box when there is so little oxygen in the air. These are problems that need to be sorted out through some sort of clever means, and when I figure out what those clever means are, I will let you know. But something that's not been performing very well for a couple of episodes now is, of course, this sleet wheat farm. Sleet wheat is a very picky crop. It likes to only grow at minus 5 degrees, around below 5 degrees, down to minus 20 something. And unfortunately, having all the hot water being poured into the cold biome is warming up the area, and it means that the sleet wheat farm is not producing anymore. So I go ahead and remove the entire sleet wheat farm. We're going to use that for chilling area. We're going to put a load of weave warts down instead. Another problem that we've got is the fact that these two pumps are trying to output into the same pipe, and as suspected, this means that every now and then the pump further down the line can't output because it thinks its pipe is full, which is a little bit annoying, but is not insurmountable. As you can see, these extra pipes will very quickly solve that problem by providing an alternate route for the gas to flow, and that way they won't like end up stacking up both in the same pipe. It's a little annoying because I was kind of hoping that as one can produce like 5 kilograms and the other one can produce 5 kilograms and the pipe can take a maximum of 10, I was kind of hoping they would combine, but no, it turns out if there is 5 kilograms in the pipe and it wants to produce another 5 kilograms in the pipe, you've got to wait until it's a junction until they will join them up together. That's a little vexing, but not the end of the world. What is kind of annoying is the fact that some hydrogen has got into our oxygen line there. Not ideal, but thankfully the fact that we have got some like air vents and stuff like that should allow that to escape before it actually goes into the system. Fingers crossed that's how it works. And if that's not actually exactly how it works, we were lucky and it managed to vent out because we didn't have any damage done to any of our exosuits. So big thumbs up all round there, I think. We're going to put a lot more gold in for production, and at some point I've really got to get around to making a proper smeltery somewhere so that we can like produce stuff in an efficient manner instead of like getting half the amount out and a whole load of sand, which is the system that we've got on the go at the moment. So you can see there is a pump up top and that is collecting hydrogen pretty nicely there. I want to get this pressure sensor sorted out so that we can restrict the amount of hydrogen that gets moved. Obviously if we just turn the pipe on and it just keeps on flooding, eventually we're going to like start pulling a vacuum at the top and pulling the oxygen up into that space. Remember how I was saying that the right hand side of the cold water tank is getting a little bit too cold? I'm actually going to rip down those temperature shift plates over there and concentrate my cooling efforts on the left hand side, which is where the pump is. So hopefully when it gets cooled down to like too far, if you will, it'll already be getting pumped out. I keep expecting these guys that are going up this ladder to be actually going and doing some digging, but repeatedly all they do is go and pick stuff up there. I don't know, I kept on wanting to use it as some sort of like segue to talk about what's going on up that way. It turns out that all they're doing is moving stuff. I was going to talk about the wonders of exploration and getting resources and opening up new spaces, but that's not actually how it works. So yeah, we're just going to kill time by talking about what I wanted to talk about instead. These temperature shift plates seem to take a little bit of time to actually get moving, but with the advent of the water flow, I'm hoping that shortly, very shortly indeed, we're going to have the situation where we can start making life loaf again. So the biggest problem with the dropping water level is that it takes the water below the reach of the hand pump, and without the hand pump, we can't move water to the kitchen devices because for some reason they can only take like little jugs of water as opposed to like turning a tap on in them for some reason. I'm not entirely sure why, but it's the restriction Clay have put into place. So that's the big problem with the water, and that's why I've been making such efforts to try and get the water flowing. Whilst the digging continues up top, or rather the moving of the slime continues up top, I'm having a look down below and looking at the wires on the left being like, guys, why is nobody working here? And of course the thing that we actually needed was a little bit of gold, and that's why people kept on climbing up. I thought they were going for slime. It turns out I judged them too harshly. I thought they were just wasting time like Shrouticus here moving slime around. And I say wasting time, but let's be honest, the more algae we have, the more oxygen we have, the better our duplicants feel about their situation. I mean, I can't imagine what it is to walk around a colony where you are starving of oxygen almost all the time. The horrors, the stress, the absolute agony that it must be. But of course, duplicants are not real people. They're just simulations of people, right? That this is how we feel okay about what we do to these creatures that we have imbued with the essence, or at least the illusion of human-like responses. There is a question question, though. You know, if something, like, looks sad, does that necessarily mean it is sad? Or is it just been programmed to have that response? Okay, so having a look at this little flow of oxygen here, you can see that it's not quite flowing smoothly. It keeps getting up to the turn towards the exosuit, and then, like, has a little stop. And I think this is actually a little bug in the game or something like that, where if an exosuit is full of oxygen, the oxygen still stops and does a check instead of just flowing on past. So at some point, I'm going to have to think about the rewiring of that. Looking at the hot water tanks, I'm fairly happy with the way they have been set out. Looking forward to being able to upgrade the bottom tank there. And looking around for consumables for oxygen seems to be going good. I'd like to completely encase that water so that we can start digging out the slime around from it as well. I'm now taking a longer time to study this pressure valve down the bottom here. I want to know what point the pressure is most optimal. I think I want to have the hydrogen actually spilling out of that little cubby hole a little bit and keeping the oxygen nice and down low. So again, we watched the oxygen flow in relatively quickly when it needed refilling. Look at the... I took the pipe away. When the oxygen needed refilling, the exosuits flowed as quickly... Sorry, the oxygen in the pipe flowed as quickly as you would imagine it to go through an empty pipe. But when it was full, it kind of stopped and jetted around a bit. So I put in this second branch, as you can see we're doing there. That'll take hopefully half the oxygen down and around and like sidestep the system. We've got a little bit of a reach issue here, but with the power of the high priority, Sir Steve can come along and make things beautiful, unless he was just going to deliver. And actually, we need Ruby to come along and do the buildings. Okay, that's fine. That is cool. I do wish that he could, like, set up the jobs a little better. Having people turn up, make deliveries, and then run away when they are more than capable of making the digs, it's not best. But there we go. With the gas pipe set up, you can see it flows at normal rate, and it's actually backfilling the oxygen in. I'm not sure whether I like that or not, but you know what? It's a working system, so we're going to just let that going, and it actually lets the oxygen flow amazingly well to the other airlock and solves the issue that we were having of not enough oxygen flowing out that way. But the hydrogen is flowing a little bit too quickly. You can see that we are getting oxygen encroaching up into the little pressurized vent that we had at the top there, and I would like to not let that happen. Another thing that I would like to not happen is that exosuit that is on the floor. I would like to put that into an actual dock there, and I'm going to do that. But with that, I am going to say thank you very much for joining for this adventure, ladies and gentlemen. I will see you next time, where we're going to go around, maybe explore some of the more dark areas we've got. I really want to try and do something with the cool steam vent that we've got, but I will see you then when we're going to do that. Bye!